Good evening, and thank you for logging on to WMUR.com. I'm meteorologist Haley LaPointe with a look at your forecast. We had a warm Wednesday. Take a look at some of these temperatures, a good 15 degrees in some communities above the average for this time in November. 65 degrees in Hillsboro, Milford, Derry coming in at 64, Bow and Claremont right near 60 degrees or even a couple degrees above that. The thing is, all this is about to change. In the central part of the U.S., we have some very frigid air. Its grips holding tight over Bismarck, Minneapolis. Look at Denver. Temperatures there have only been in the single digits today. That's some real chilly air for this time in November. Look at Cleveland, even Memphis. Temperatures there in the 30s. That's more like what we will be seeing as we get closer and closer to the weekend. This is the setup right now. We have this huge area of cold air that has come down from Canada in the central part of the U.S. And the jet stream, which is usually the boundary between cold air and warm air, it's this ribbon up in the upper atmosphere of fast-moving air. And eventually this is going to move off toward the east of us, and that will bring in this cold plume of air for Friday and into the weekend, and it'll be some of the coldest air we have felt so far this fall season. We had one cold front move through today, and you might have even driven through a couple of light rain showers or drizzle. Now the clouds are clearing out, and that will signal some cool temperatures during the overnight hours, of course, with clear skies. That tends to happen. So we'll fall into the 30s in a lot of communities. Check out what's happening in the Great Lakes there. You've got all that cold air going right over the warm lake water, and that's producing lake effect snow. Pretty crazy. And that's going to happen too, right up in the Tug Hill Plateau over the next couple of days or so. Some big snow expected there. You can actually see it on Futurecast there, right to the south of Watertown, New York. But closer to home here, we're looking at sunshine tomorrow, at least for the beginning of the day, and then clouds are going to fill in during the afternoon and evening. The commute home tomorrow night, no problems, but the commute into work on Friday morning could be a little bit of a different story, especially in the southern part of the state. A weak system is going to move through during the overnight hours. It's about 1:30 in the morning, and it likely will be cold enough that we'll see snow, and it may stick in a few places, especially, you know, on the grassy surfaces, maybe your car, possibly even to the ground, but not expecting anything more than maybe an inch or two in these communities. But the timing of this is what is important, because it's during the commute time, or right when you'd be heading out and commuting into work Friday morning. So something to keep in mind. Check in with us again tomorrow. We'll be able to get a better idea of how much snow we're talking there and the timing, but could be a little bit slick on Friday. Then that system goes away, and we're looking at a lot of sunshine for our weekend, at least for the start of the weekend. Tonight, the clouds are going to clear, cold settles in, temperatures upper 20s, low 30s. Tomorrow in the southeastern part of the state, everybody in the 40s instead of 60s. It's going to feel real chilly there with increasing clouds. Sunapee and over in the mid-40s there. 44 degrees in Tamworth, only 37 in Lincoln. 40 degrees Lancaster, 41 in Littleton, with clouds on the increase. So maybe some warning snow showers on Friday, then clearing out. Saturday, cold and sunny, only 36 degrees. And then there could be another shot of some snow late Sunday and into Monday of next week.